What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. So today I've got 5 tricks or tips when using Adobe InDesign that you're going to find really useful for your graphic design projects. This video is going to be a quick fire tutorial where I bang out some tricks and tips for you guys in Adobe InDesign. The first Adobe InDesign tip or trick in today's InDesign tutorial is a pretty neat one. If we take the rectangle tool from here, we can not only add an image or an object to just one box, we can in fact spread that image across multiple boxes in InDesign. This is an awesome trick within InDesign for making magazines and other print media look more interesting. You can use the Alt Option key to duplicate the boxes like so across your document. When ready, select every single box at once, and then go up to Object, Paths, and make Compound Path. Now all of these boxes are united in unison. When you then go up to place an image or an object in the selection of boxes, InDesign will show you across the entire box selection. Now I personally think this is really neat. The next trick in today's InDesign tutorial again is based around imagery and boxes. You might very well be bored with a rectangle box for your image and your design. To change that, simply go up to Object, Change Shape, and then choose from a list of options here. I think the triangle shape looks pretty cool with this space image. So the third InDesign tip or trick in today's tutorial is a keyboard shortcut for something relating to typography. If you press Command, Option and 7 on a Mac, or Control, Alt, 7 on a PC, you can swap between paragraph settings and type settings at the top here. This means you do not have to leave the text box and open up the paragraph window over and over when working with typography in Adobe InDesign. The Pipette tool is a tool across many Adobe programs. However, within Adobe InDesign, there's an option that allows you not only to sample one color from a design or an image, but you can sample various different colors that are within that image. This is pretty handy and a cool addition to Adobe InDesign. The last Adobe InDesign tip or trick in today's tutorial is pretty important. If you go up to Window, Output, and then Preflight, this box should appear. This is going to help you know when you have an error whilst working within Adobe InDesign. So for example, you might have an image that's not linked to your document. You can check the On button in the top left corner to make sure this function is working whilst you work in Adobe InDesign. That was today's InDesign tutorial on tips and tricks by Satori Graphics. So that was today's video on 5 tips or tricks when using Adobe InDesign for your graphic design projects. Let me know what you guys thought of today's video right down in the comment section below. And of course, drop a like if you did enjoy it or find it useful. Share my content on social media so other people can find my content and implement these techniques in their graphic design workflow. If you want to see more Adobe InDesign tutorials on this channel, don't be afraid or shy to drop a comment and let me know. I'm always trying to accommodate videos that are relevant to you guys and what you want to learn here at Satori Graphics. But yeah, until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.